नमस्ते, आई एम डॉक्टर मयूर वी काको। आई एम अ न्यूरोसर्जन हु ऑपरेट्स ऑन ब्रेन एंड स्पाइन। एंड यू माइट वंडर व्हाई अ न्यूरोसर्जन हैज टू स्पीक ऑन गृहस्थ आश्रम। ट्रू, इवन आई थॉट सो। बिफोर दिस वीडियो आई हैव स्पोकन ऑन or made 100 plus videos on yoga. At that time, before starting this channel, before putting the videos on yoga, I used to put videos on brain and spine surgery. However, as all people, I am also a traveler in life, and as a sadhak or as a seeker, question came to my mind, am I only a neurosurgeon? Am I not a son, a brother, a friend, a husband, father, teacher, mentor, patient, customer, citizen, and what not? I have many roles. Above all, I am a human being. This self-realization led me to shed the fear of being judged by others, and I started uploading videos on yoga and neuroscience. Rest you all know. Now there are many people who got benefited and they have been leading healthy lifestyle. They are not only free of their pain in the back or neck, but many have been able to normalize their blood sugars and blood pressures and have become drug free. Even today morning, I got messages from many people saying Happy World Family Day. Beautiful. I was very happy. I wished my family the same. However, after some time, I got a message on WhatsApp from a 72-year-old gentleman whose 49 years long marriage is on the line because of his own mistakes. He asked me to become his guru and guide him to clear the problem. This was overwhelming for me, and let me tell you one thing. Many people come and tell stories about their life, softening their mistakes. They will be very soft to their own mistakes. This gentleman, however, is one of the rare personalities I have ever met, who has been so blunt, so brutal about self-analysis. And he has changed himself for the good to save his 49 years of marriage and having kids who are now 48 years, 47 years and 32 years of age. Now question came to me, should I be making videos on Grihastashrama? Before deciding on this, I had this question. On deeper analysis, I was able to convince myself, when it is clear to me what is my goal in life, then it is okay for me to do it. So what is my goal in life and what our goal in life should be? All of us, as mentioned earlier, play many roles in our lives. Son, brother, daughter, sister, father, mother, uncle, doctor, patient, husband, wife, and so on. Being a Grihastha is one such role which I have been playing since last 9 years. Also, I have been fortunate enough to observe few years of 50 plus years of marriage of my grandparents, where I could see the magic of companionship in between them. My grandmother, when she was married at a very young age, was illiterate to start with, and my grandfather taught her how to read, how to write, and she went on to learn Jyotish Shastra from him. Even later on, she learned English from us, her grandchildren, and she could read and write English. She was a great tapaswini also, as we observed her as kids. Even I was fortunate enough to learn great deal of yoga and mudras from her. There is a long story about her being the reason for excavation of 14th century Sati's stone plate 1300 kilometers away from where we used to live. However, I will save this story for the later part of the video series. As I saw my father later on, in his marriage, I could see him motivating my mother to work and gave her opportunities so that she could successfully work with Life Insurance Corporation of India, that is LIC of India, for 25 plus years, along with my father, who was working in Bank of India for 35 plus years. As children, even though we saw them very busy, they never neglected us and always motivated us to become good human beings. Result: a gold medalist neurosurgeon speaking to all of you, and a chartered accountant, that is my younger brother. Both of us, including our parents and grandparents, well versed in the practice of yoga and the knowledge of the scriptures. As a neurosurgeon, however, I will come back to my profession. As a neurosurgeon, as a doctor, we have different observational skills. Due to the prolonged exposure to patients and their relatives, many a times, as doctors, we knowingly or unknowingly influence patients and their families. Because of the yoga background, I have always been at a place where patients, their relatives have sought more than brain and spine advices. Actually, this YouTube channel is the result of many of my patients asking me to send videos of breathing exercises or spondylosis treatment or mudras for various ailments. Even though I was busy, I could think about them and their desperate need for the advices with respect to yoga, and I started making videos. Patient reviews, which are there on this channel, are the result of one of my anesthesia doctor colleague. She told me that, "See Mayur, people are putting vulgar videos, violent videos, videos of reviews of many materialistic things. Why don't you put your own talent? Why don't you put the yoga videos and the patients who become better because of the practice of yoga? This will motivate people and spread positivity. Why don't you do so?" And yes, here we got our goal, the goal of life. What is that goal? Motivate each other and spread positivity. Now, I am clear. I have more than one role of just being a neurosurgeon. And I am clear that all of us should have this goal in life, despite our qualifications, academic credentials. We all should be great motivators and we all should be the spreaders of positivity. So, 72-year-old sir, here I am to motivate not only you, not only your family, but also all the families, to give them the recipe to make each other amongst us to feel valid, to feel being loved in the truest sense possible. Now question is, why family have problems? Why somebody who has a long marriage of 49 years is feeling invalid, unsatisfied? Don't worry, I am not going to the details of this case, but however, I am going to the root cause, because this case is just a representation of our poor state of affairs in the family matters in many families all across the planet. So I am going to strike on the root cause. Root cause? Isn't it already described? We play multiple roles. We need to play them. And every role is demanding. Be it father, be it husband, be it a professional. Any role we take in our life is demanding and has a component of ego of its own. Sometimes we enjoy one role more and we neglect other roles. We don't feel like working on the sluggish roles and we don't give our 100%. Another deep-rooted problem is we don't recognize if somebody else is putting 100% effort. This neglect of other people putting their 100% is one of the reasons for us not to forgive. And that is why we start being harsh on our own family members. Forgiving is one thing, and another thing is that mistakes which have happened should not be repeated. So both the things are very, very important. Forgiving and not repeating the mistake. One more thing for all the people, that only strong people can forgive. Weak people can keep grudges. Mistakes, as we know, they happen in any role by anybody. But the true happiness lies in the learning from all these mistakes and forgiving and accepting the story. Because this is not an ordinary story. This is not the story which you are going to read again and again. Because this is the story of your own life. So it is fine. It is fine. Even if 49 years have gone, it's fine. It's fine to be late than never. Always remember all the family members, that past will give you sadness, future will give you anxiety. But if you be in the present, it is called as a gift. Enjoy it without any conditions applying. We know that life does not come with a replay button and it does not come with an expiry date. So please, I urge all the families who are listening to this, that in our ancient scriptures it is written Dhanyo Gruhastha Ashramaha, which means that the family life is the greatest. We all know there are four ashramas as described in our ancient scriptures: Brahmacharya Ashrama, Gruhastha Ashrama, वानप्रस्थ आश्रम एंड संन्यास आश्रम. माइंड यू, गृहस्थ आश्रम कैन टीच मोर थिंग्स विच इवन ब्रह्मचर्य आश्रम और संन्यास आश्रम कंबाइंड कैन नॉट. ट्राई टू लर्न, ट्राई टू लर्न एंड एंजॉय द प्रैक्टिकल लेसन्स ऑफ लाइफ इन दिस गृहस्थ आश्रम. नॉलेज इन द बुक्स इज यूजलेस अकॉर्डिंग टू वॉट आई हैव अंडरस्टूड इन माई लाइफ. द नॉलेज इन द बुक्स इज यूजलेस अंटिल एंड अनलेस इट इज अप्लाइड प्रैक्टिकली. द कोट्स, द श्लोकास, द मंत्रास, दे आर ऑल्सो यूजलेस इफ दे आर नॉट इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन आवर लाइव्स. धन्य गृहस्थ आश्रम. गृहस्थ आश्रम कैन बिकम ग्रेट ओनली वेन वी द गृहस्थास मोटिवेट ईच अदर एंड स्प्रेड पॉजिटिविटी इन ईच अदर्स लाइव्स. वी लव ईच अदर अनकंडीशनली. वी फॉरगिव, वी फॉरगेट जस्ट to enjoy the greatest moments of life. The moments of life are called the present moments. Now I will take you to slightly zoomed out picture. We zoomed in towards the family. As the family, we know that family is made up of its members, one person at a time. Yoga helps each and every individual. When individual is sorted, yoga will help the family to become sorted. When the family is sorted, the society will become sorted. When the society is sorted out, automatically the country on a whole becomes sorted. Because country is the collection of all the human beings staying within its boundaries. And when countries are sorted, we will see a world which is better than it was previously. So don't think that what will happen if only I become good, because the goodness, it's quite more infectious than this corona. Once you start becoming good, once you start becoming the spreader of your goodness, automatically you will see not only you will blossom, your family will blossom, automatically the society will blossom with goodness. We always feel more emotional and happy at the same time when we see people doing good things. We become emotional when people do bad things also. We become sad, however. That is why don't we do the reverse? Why don't we start spreading goodness not only within us but also around us? Start with your own family. Respect the goodness in other person and respect the goodness within you. Thank you very much, because this is not only about your own family, it is about the complete world which is revolving around you. You don't just realize it. That is why there is one more saying in Sanskrit which is called as Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. This whole world, this whole universe is my family. It has a very deep meaning. I urge all of you to introspect, to contemplate on these two shlokas, that is Dhanya Gruhastha Ashramah and Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. With this, I thank all of you for listening patiently, and I would be posting various interesting topics on this aspects of family management with respect to our ancient scriptures. You can suggest me topics. I will correlate with the ancient scriptures, and I will also correlate with the neuroscience as I do. You can go through my channel, you can see the neuroscience and yoga joining hands together, and we will try to resolve the issues from the root. rather than trying to do patchwork. And remember that all of us, as we all know, that if we throw the root cause of the problem out, then there will not be any need to punish anybody or to punish the person who has committed mistake, because we need to punish the cause rather than the person. With that understanding, I take leave from all of you. Dhanyavada. We all will chant the mantra for the whole world, that is Om. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya, sarve badrani pashyantu, ma kaschit dukhabhag bhave. Om shantihi, shantihi, shantihi. Let us all of us together be healthy, together be happy, together be prosperous. None of us should suffer, and all of us should live in peace and harmony along with all other living creatures, that is plants and animals. Dhanyavaad. Have a nice day.